Hey, welcome to The 6-Inch Show, episode 64. Even though I said 64 last week, this is really, really 64 this time. I am Fly Guy from FlyGuy.net, joined as always by Mr. Matt from Instagram.com, Star Wars, The Black Series, and many other channels. I see you've got the new cool, no, that's not new, is it?
No, it's not new. I've used it before.
There's a brand new Mickey Lego or something around just now, so everybody seems to be buying it.
I'm not sure what there is. I know that there's new Mario Lego, and there's all that new Star Wars Lego art and stuff, which is
cool. I know there's a ton of weird toys out these days. Anyway, we're not here to talk about Lego. We're here to talk about 6-inch figures, predominantly Hasbro and a little bit of SHF Figuarts, Bandai, and a few others tonight we shall cover, from Star Wars to Marvel, and a few bits and pieces more. As always, there is the juicy part of the show coming up pretty soon, which is all the really cool toy photography from some of the best creators and photographers out there on the nets. Stay tuned. All the links are in the description below underneath the video, and let's go. So the very first thing we're going to talk about is one new image cropped up this week. Let me share this screen for you. And this popped up, which was the new card backs for the new Star Wars we've, Dorsey Toys posted it on Instagram. I thought it was kind of cool just to see the backs of these things. I know it's not really super exciting, but I'm sure you probably saw that as well. But I love the way the art is not only on the back of the card now, it's on the side of the card now as well. It's much more collectible. But Darth, Kamino Trooper, and all these number ones everywhere. It's kind of like, what? But then it's all this colored lines. So Akbar's one, Beskar Mandalorian's one. So yeah, I don't know. I think this may actually make people collect these more actually in cards. But
look, I think it does. I think, you know, I like the red and black boxes when they came out. I've always loved Gregory Titus's art. But at 112 figures, they needed a phase reboot.
Totally.
If not at 99, they needed it at like 75 when The Last Jedi came out or whatever it was. They should have had a package refresh earlier than what they've got now.
Mm. No, I agree. It is...
Comments from last week?
Comments from last week, of course. See, this is why you're here. Let's go back and have a look at that show. So I get distracted because we were talking about that thing. But anyway, this is what we're talking about. So yes, before we dive into Star Wars episode 63, the real 63, not the 64. Let's take a look at your comments and see what was said. And what did we have here? We had some comments. We had a bunch of stuff. I'll zoom this up so people can see it. Talking about comic books. Hush, he was talking about there. So some fans of Hush were in there too. G.I. Joe is liked by Elias Angelius. Quite right, you love it too. Should be some more G.I. Joe coming up soon, very soon, given STCC is round the corner. Absorvids is quite into the new card backs. He likes them too. I just realized this week, of course, there's a kind of clear piece at the top of the box. I didn't quite click that was on the box as well. So the light kind of shines in the box. So they're really very...
So they've gone back to the original Black Series boxes used to have.
Correct. So it should make quite a bit of difference to the display of the figure. Christopher Miller is asking for the Galaxy's Edge mouse droids. That's a very good point, actually, because that's the only place you can really get them.
That's a $9.99,
it's very easy one, isn't it?
A Porg and a Baby Yoda. I'd take a $9.99 mouse droid.
Somebody wants Haslab X-Wing. Yep, that's a good point. Could be. Optimus figures, talking about those Transformers we talked about last week, the Walmart currently exclusive line of non-transforming figures. Thank you. Red line Transformers. Correct. Thank you, Matt. BakerScape74, hello again. He says he really enjoyed the episode. Liking the G.I. Joes and Empire Strikes Back Wave. That's cool. God, everybody's very nice and civil. Hello, Kenneth Creeley Jr., fan of the show every week. Love you, dude. Return of the Jedi, HasLab. Yeah, everyone's getting excited about that. Usual Mike was talking about G.I. Joe figures. Yeah, I agree. They're just, they're really, I'm desperate to get hold of them. Really looking forward to them. Justin Riley's talking about the original trilogy and what he likes there. What hashtags does Matt search on Instagram? So
it's hashtag TBSFF. That is the one for FF. The Black Series Friday features, band features, whatever you want to call it, TBSFF.
There you go, Christopher Miller one. Or Christopher Miller 1 week ago. Everybody's talking about G.I. Joe. Wow. Michael Bell, another great show, guys. Thank you, dude. G.I. Joe, talking about G.I. Joe there. Anfield Fox 82 got a shout out last time at 42.52 within the show. You're getting a second one. There you go.
And a lot sooner.
A lot sooner of the show. Native Rain 789 is talking about Dooku and all those waves, which we're just going to talk about as well, which are just heading story.
He's also asking if memory serves me, if we think that these latest waves will get re-released in the new packaging because they make up so many Attack of the Clones and whatever it is. And my feeling is no. I think that... maybe down the line, but it's not going to be a sudden re-release like Rebels or anything like that.
Yep. No, I agree with that. I think you're absolutely right. They're too soon. Too soon. Darth Emmett says, nice show. Thank you, dude. 40th anniversary is excited about talking about Joes. Everybody's loving Joes. Very good video and underrated channel. Thank you, Tan Lee, Star Wars Women, Coruscant Jedi, Tan Lee. That's very nice of you. More Joe comments. Any plans for another realm recap? Miss it a lot. I just, Jason and I are in different time zones and it's just hell. I'm really sorry. Otolith 5. We will try. We'd still keep in touch, but yeah, really, really busy. It's really hard. For Black Series HasLab project, an entire Jedi Council set. That's kind of interesting, actually, but don't think it'll happen, though. Daniel Woodhouse is talking about you already got your shipping notification for Zarkus. We did. We got them in between shows, so we've had them and reviewed them and so forth.
Crush them.
Oh my God, the crushed handed carbonates. God, don't get me started. How did yours arrive? Crushed.
One hand turned up perfect.
Yeah.
One hand and another hand was crushed. And I also had another one come as a single hand for a friend who's overseas at the moment. So that when it arrives when he gets back in Australia, when he's allowed back in, and I've got it sitting here waiting for him. And he's just got smashed kind of thing. It was a one card thing. And even if the fold didn't get it, the guy who delivered it, put it into the letterbox or folded up. It was just like, you assholes.
Like, I saw when they literally exclusives. Folded the cardboard, then they folded it again. And it's like, really? Anyway,
I have honestly seen 40th anniversary. I think it was a Hoth Luke. Was in a box from Amazon and they cut the top of the box off, the top of the packet off. It wasn't even folded. It was like just cut off to fit into this square box. And I was just like, oh, Amazon, you're worse than Walmart.
It's shocking. The amount of money they must have wasted on reshipping out to people. Took them 4 attempts with me to get it right. 4 attempts. And even then they were still about like, eh. Anyway. A lot of friends were very happy. I was like, here, have a hand of carbonate, screwed. Anyway, just back to some comments very quickly. The very last of those comments there. The Battlestar. God, everybody's, you guys are so nice. We're not paying you, I promise. But the Battlestar 1 was another great show. He enjoyed that. Transformers, he's excited about 2 there. Anyone who's complaining about Boba and Darth on an Empire card that looks that good is just... a toy buyer and not a real collector. Kind of have to agree. I mean, you're buying it for the cardboard and the display. Imperial Tech was saying Forbidden Planet shipping to Australia is very expensive. Yeah, I thought it was. Dark Side Toy shipping to Australia is a reasonable price. Yes, I agree. And that is all your comments. Ton of them. Thank you, guys and gals, for all your stuff you wrote in. But we hear you. G.I. Joe is exciting stuff. So I kind of jumped ahead. Star Wars, we talked about the figure backs, figure card backs from the upcoming wave or waves. And the other one we just missed in between the show was the fact that we got a reissued Jango Fett, which is now under the guise Gaming Greats for GameStop and Zing in Australia and New Zealand. Still no word. I think it was Star Action Figures in the UK from memory. It was. So there's no gaming aspect for them because there's no game store selling them. But Jango is back. He has a tweaked facial scan head, and GameStop's photographs are not the best, it has to be said. Let me actually just dig out some, I think I've got some pictures here, and we'll have a look at better quality pictures. Come on, Windows, in your own time. So yeah, we're getting a Jango back again, tweaked, modded. And if this folder will hurry up and open, my God, Windows, what are you doing to me? Anyway, well, we're waiting. The only real difference is the rocket, the jetpack. But apart from that, same figure, even down to the paint looks pretty much the same. I don't see mega difference at all. Do you?
I think that the paint is a little bit cleaner.
Yeah,
I think
it was
a bit more scuffed up, and this looks like a very clean silver. So that's about the only difference, that the photo reel and the jetpack. The jetpack is a repaint of Boba Fett's pack, and that was the pack he had in the Bounty Hunter game, as opposed to what he had in Attack of the Clones, which looks more like Mandalorian's jetpack.
Here we go. So, yeah, we'll get the
game. He used this jetpack as well when he tried to by the bomb at Anakin.
But in the game, if I remember right, he does have multiple jetpacks and he uses them both.
Does he?
Like, I was addicted to that game, man. In fact, it still stands to me as some of the best story CGI for any Star Wars game, and in fact for many other games. It really made the story something else. It was just a shame the game itself wasn't that good. But love the artwork, Star Wars Bounty Hunter logo on there. Looking very nice indeed. And there we go, as we said, there's pictures of... Yeah, I think you're right, Pete. Certainly on this prototype, this glam shot, it looks super clean. Which is maybe to try and capture the game, I guess.
The game look, yeah.
Yeah. As subtle as it is, I think you're right. It's definitely... And that looks 100% like Boba's jetpacks. I don't think they've made a new one. The grey undertones, yeah, that's a little different. You're right, on the paint's a lot sharper. A lot less weathering and scuffing and all the rest. So pretty much the same, but there we go. And it's got one of those, unfortunately, and it'll vary, I'm sure, but pretty awful shiny faces. I hope they can rectify that, because that is a bit of a shame.
Yeah, I'm sure they will. It doesn't look as good a photo reel as we've been getting, and I'm going to put it back down to an early prototype.
Yeah, I think so.
Because they've all been coming out pretty good at the moment. And then the other thing we're finally going to get it's not only just a better photo reel face, eyes and all that stuff, we're actually going to get eyebrows that aren't sitting halfway up his forehead.
There was so many of them on shelves for years that had that.
Yes. I always liked the one where I saw one once which had it crooked, and it was like one was low and one was high.
Yeah. That's mad. So there we go. Jango Fett Gaming Greats, looking good.
I think it's due September.
That's right, yeah. That's right. So looking forward to that, even though it's kind of just basically a repack. A lot of people not too super happy with this. It went in and out of stock at GameStop. It's back in stock. I think from memory, it was EB Games in Canada, just to be global. Yes, it was. And Star Action Figures in the UK. So you have no excuse, really, unfortunately, for France, Germany, and thousands of countries, hundreds of countries.
Oh, no. I'm pretty sure Star Action ships to Europe. They just don't ship to Australia anymore or America, etc. Awesome. But they still ship within the EU.
Yep.
So yeah. France and Germany can all get it from Star Action still.
Perfect. So there's very few countries that can't get it. So go out and support the line and go pick it up because it's a great figure. And again, you get some updates. So sell your old one. So there we go. That is Gaming Greats Jango Fett. And that concludes nearly Star Wars, apart from one other figure, which is kind of cool. I swear I thought we talked about this, but we're going to talk about it again.
We've spoken about it when they leaked the picture out.
Oh, okay.
May 4th.
So there we go. And it does look really good. Bandai IG-11, so not Black Series, sadly. But yeah, that does look rather nice. The Hasbro one was definitely very rushed, not screen accurate, and just, yeah, pretty terrible.
Just a re-release of the
other
bad IG-11.
The cheek to call that an exclusive was really quite taking the piss. But you can buy it now from Dorksy Toys, BBTS, and loads of other places because it's back as a fan channel exclusive. But yeah, this is a nice addition here. Is the well, it's not an addition, as it quite rightly says there. The child is not included. But I kind of wish they had that.
Is the backpack?
Yeah, it's the backpack and Baby Yoda, which is not included. That's a bit of a shame. I really had wished they'd had. But looks nice, nice colours, nice screen accurate stuff. This belt looks ridiculously new and not quite right from memory, but there we go. I'm sure it is. All the different angles. And there he is with the SH figure arts. Go ahead.
Just if you want to do it, if you go to the Fawoosh, you'll see that Robo has done, he's put the Black Series picture and tried to scale it compared to the SH figure arts one. And it does what it shows one really interesting thing. I just thought
let's
just
have a look. We'll do it. Let me share my screen again. I guess we should search IG-11.
I'll tell you where it is if you scroll down.
Oh, okay.
It'll be
there you go. Is this what you're talking
about? No, go down further or higher. Oh no, it's in the weekly show notes on the main page. Scroll down and down. There we go. Underneath, back up. It's underneath the Sentinel.
Is it?
Up one more. We've gone too far down and up one more. Yeah. Into that one, yep. This is exciting stuff, everybody.
It is.
There we go.
This is important stuff. Oh, okay. I see what he's done there. So
look at that size of the two of them next to each other.
Jeez, yeah. You're right. God, the IG Hasbro one looks terrible there.
It looks like the 3.75 inch one.
It does, doesn't it? Well, that's really what it is. It's just an upscaled version of. Yeah, we need a new IG 11. That sucks. That's pretty bad. Good call. So that's it for Star Wars. That's all the new bits and pieces there. Some other stuff that has appeared in the Hasbro line, which got announced was, I at first thought this was Evel Knievel, because that's what it reminded me of. There you go, this is something to take you way back from kids that remember. Do you remember that as a kid, the toy?
Yeah.
Do you?
Yeah.
Wind up shit.
Pull it, zip it. Oh, no, we didn't wind it. We had a pull one, and we'd pull it, and the black, you'd pull the black, jagged
string.
Oh, you and the engine would go, and then would go up and over, and you'd have the hoop and all that stuff. But yeah, I saw Evel Knievel at the Easter show. He used to come out here to the Easter show all the time.
What? That's crazy.
Evel Knievel used to come to Australia all the time for the Easter show.
Oh my God, I don't even know what the Easter show was. Anyway, this reminds me of Evel Knievel was this Lightning Collection Hasbro Power Rangers SPD Uniforce cycle. It just looks really cool, I thought. although not a great photo. But there you go. That's kind of cool. I like that. If you're into Power Rangers and the Lightning Collection, the kind of quality, more quality collection stuff from Hasbro, this is their first vehicle in the line. So there you go. Yeah, lots and lots of Power Rangers stuff to come. There's more Putty Men and all sorts of, just the line is exploding at a rate that I can't quite follow. But there you go. If you're into that, then that is one. And just where we're on screen, here's the other one. San Diego Comic-Con, yet Amazon exclusive release, which is this. Another Lightning Collection, Space Psycho Rangers. Sounds like something of Donald Trump's Space Force. But there you go. You've got five very similar figures with slight repaints. And if this floats your boat, then I just love the packaging. I thought it looked really cool. But In Space Psycho Rangers. So there we go. Lots and lots of similarity here in the figures, if you're into that. There you go. They look kind of cool, but kind of cheesy too. So there you go. That is currently not available. It was available, but it's now gone. So, but I would imagine we'll be back in time, just like a lot of products that Amazon do. They list stuff and then it disappears. So there's a link in the show notes if you really want to.
Surely next week again with virtual yeah. San Diego Comic-Con.
I guess. I don't know why it went up early, but it did. Something really big to talk about, and by big we mean 26 inches, I think. In fact, 26.6 inches. If you weren't aware, Hasbro had an online live event, and during that event, even though they'd hinted it at a previous event, the shared this HasLab project. You must have heard of this if you're into Marvel Legends. They released this massive Marvel Legends Sentinel from the X-Men, and they went through all the details with it. The 40 points of articulation, is it, or something?
No, more. 72 points.
72 points. That's right, because all the fingers, like a hot toy, are all super articulated. Not only that, but it comes with a figure with swap out head, Bastion, and the Prime Sentinel, if I remember. Limited at 5 per transaction. It sold out really quickly. Well, not sold out. It reached its current...
reached its backing, its funding rate.
Yep.
Which was 6,000 in, I think, 27 or 28 hours or something.
That's right.
And it hit 8,000 or 7,000, which unlocked... Is it this head?
It was that one.
This head? Yeah. It reached that about 3 hours later. That's and right. It's now halfway at 8,500 towards unlocking the battle-damaged Sentinel with another unlock again at 9,000.
The battle damage is done.
It is? Okay. And yeah.
Partly so.
Of course, 8,000, yeah.
So they're up to 8,500 now. So
now we're waiting for what the 9,000 reveal is.
Which we don't know what it is. So
and there's 42 days, 16 hours and 4 minutes left. So, you know, look, I'm gonna say it now. A, it's something that people wanted. B, it was at a price at $350, which is expensive, but it's not $500 or $600.
Yep.
It's not Unicron / Sale Barge. It's big. But it doesn't require its own room, its own table, its own... Look, you buy... Oh, look, it's not going to be standing, in all honesty, any bigger than those Jax Pacific Star Wars figures that kids have.
Yeah, but even then... You know those? Don't be wrong, I'd love one. But display and storage and where the hell... So
he stands up on the floor. He stands up on the floor. Like the sail barge needs its own table that is so big. Yeah, it's too big for a shelf and all that stuff. This actually even stands behind a door. Like this is my point.
Listen, you're justifying why you need one.
Oh no, I'm not going to get it. I'm not going to get it.
I know.
I'm pointing out at $350, it's like what, two hot toy figures in America?
That's true. That is that's true. A basic
hot. That's why I think it's back so quickly, apart from the fact that it's wanted. It's not taking a full month's rent kind of thing. It's like
yeah,
half a month.
Exactly. I said to someone on YouTube, I did a quick video and we talked about it, and I said, I can never go over the fact a Sentinel looks as if he's wearing a beanie. And all these people are like, why did you say that? Now I can't unsee it. And so there you go, I've ruined it for other people. But he's wearing a beanie, isn't he? You know, like a rolled up beanie. It's just, why?
And, you know, we should say it's got light up eyes and a light up chest.
It does.
And the cool thing about it I saw was that you turn it on by pushing the chest light in.
Yep.
So there's no other annoying buttons or anything that ruins the design on the back or anything like that.
But it looks pretty awesome. Articulated fingers and an incredibly exclusive figure. You know, you're going to pay a lot of money to get this figure. So I imagine this will be bootleg to hell. But very cool looking. You know, doesn't come with Wolverine, but you know, you're going to want to get a Wolverine to pose with that for sure, I would imagine.
Yeah, and everyone's only got 16 Wolverines.
Yeah, exactly. So one other thing to note is if you're international, there's not a lot of details really. They said what they're going to do with that, but Dorksay Toys and BBTS have listed this, although Dorksay Toys is $50 cheaper than BBTS. But there you go. Cost a little more. You got to pay a little more to get it, but they will ship it internationally to you as well. So if you're one of those people that was really struggling, you have a chance to get the Sentinel. So there you go.
That's, again, look, people can say what they want, but it's another hats off to Hasbro. They've now found an international way of getting it to people without the sale barge dramas and having to do deals with Australian or UK or whatever. You've got two people, and speaking on behalf of Dorkside, their shipping is as good as anybody's internationally. So, yes. And I believe I haven't done much with BBTS, so yeah, I believe their shipping is still pretty good as well. Yep. But they haven't gone and done a deal with those who charge exorbitant international shipping.
Yeah, exactly. So at least you get an opportunity to get it, because the sale barge, even at the last minute, they did very briefly do that crappy eBay. They put up an eBay for scalpers got it and it's gone. That wasn't very fair. No one has been available to order for ages for US fans on Pulse. So, yeah, at least that way with BBTS and Dorksay Toys, go get it. If you want to go get it, that's the only real reasonable chance I would suggest you'll get it. It's littered on eBay already with huge, gouged markups. So, you know, it's going to be what it's going to be. So I've seen a lot of people. I think eBay is going to start pulling down the listings in 30 days because you can't pre-order something that's more than 30 days. So we'll see what happens about that. Anyway, looks cool. I like it. I'm very impressed with the HasLab presentation of those guys. They did a really good job, Dwight and Ryan. And I couldn't remember the other guy's name. You did good fun talking about it. And teased at the very end the little X-Men Beast book, which I didn't quite understand what... I guess that's got something to do with the next level backing kind of unlock feature. I don't know what it is. So there you go. If you're watching, you got it immediately, let us know. I mean, I thought it was... I don't know what it was really, actually. But it's basically looks like...
I got no idea.
Yeah, exactly. I was like, what's the book? I guess some true fan out there will know. Another product that was launched in between shows. How rude of them to do that in between shows. Terrible. Marvel Legends exclusive, fan channel exclusive, Venom Toxin. It came out for pre-order. Not much really different, really. It's just the Monster Venom body with extra tweaks. I've seen some real people loving this and a lot of people not liking it. Real love, hate. What do you think?
I'm on the hate side.
Yeah.
It's not even hate. It's more, I'm not even hate because it's just a toy. So it's more, I'm just more a bit apathetic. Yeah.
Yeah. I think like, go ahead.
I was just about to say, it just looks silly. Like, and there's no texture to the red, and there's so where Monster Venom was looking awesome, and then the Eddie Brock Venom on the monster body looked really cool to get all that stuff going. This one's like, I mean, it's a cool reuse again, and I've got no anything. I guess, look, I don't even know who Toxin is. I was out of Spider-Man by the time, obviously, Toxin turned up and all these other symbiotes and all that kind of stuff. But it's just, to me, it just looks too much. Even here with the things coming off the arm in the box, it looks better. It's this whole thing above the head. It's just too much.
Yeah, so you're right.
Obviously.
Go ahead.
Yeah. No, no, you go.
I was just going to say, this image really summed up for me the fact that, and I get the point, but not to add paint to some of the teeth and the mouths on this felt just kind of naff. It just didn't add any... Yeah, and plus he's a really ugly son of a bitch. He's like, whoa, you know, Venom's not attractive, but there's something about the character that's kind of, well, it's almost kind of smiling in some way. I don't know, it just looks really, don't know. Some people love Sugar, the Sugar Man bath, and I kind of get that point about he's so ugly and weird that people love him, but yeah, I don't know. But if you're into him, you can go get him. So we'll go order, pre-order.
And look, the Venom figure's a great figure, so yeah. I'm sure it'll look good. It's just not my cup of spider tea.
Cup of spider tea tastes like black and sticky. lots and lots of Marvel SHF figures out and about and previewed. In Japan just recently there, new Thor, Thanos, Doctor Strange, a bunch of figures were on display. There we go, final battle edition of slightly obese Thor. Doctor Strange looking really good there. That was a fantastic looking figure, I thought. Battle on Titan edition with his sword. I never realized he had a sword. Forgot about that. And doing his 14 million to one checking situation there, which was kind of nice. And Thanos as well. So there you go. There's a few of them. And there's also, there was a Tony Stark and a Black Widow. Sorry, Black Widow. Scarlet Witch.
Scarlet Witch.
Thank you.
With new eyes.
Yes, that's right. She had weird eyes before, didn't she?
No, she's got them now. She's got her fire eyes.
Oh, I see what you mean. Sorry. I thought we saw a preview of that. It was pretty janky. Anyway, and Tony Stark with his final I Am Iron Man snap. Spoiler alert. A bit late for the spoiler, but you get the point. That's it for SHF. And the last one here just to cover is the Yamaguchi figures, and one of them we've seen Deathstroke, Deadpool, and a bunch of other ones. Some really cool characters that pick very stylized. Here is Cable. He looks badass, man. 6.7 inches, so just a little taller, but in scale to 6 inch. Looking pretty amazing. All the detail, the bullets, the weapons, the arm, the silver chrome effect. The eye, it just looks straight out the comic books. Very impressive.
This is what I'd like to see from Marvel Legends.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, I still don't think we've got Bishop looking so good, and Cable just doesn't look like the Cable that should be going with Bishop. And it doesn't look like a movie Cable either, and it doesn't look like it is a Cable, no doubt, but it's kind of like, this is what we need a real blue and yellow Cable. Mm.
Lots of nice weapons over here. Lots of different attachments and an eye with the little kind of blast effect, hands and so forth. So it's a nice package, nice piece of kit all in. Lots of different poses with him. He's incredibly poseable. Just like all the other Yamaguchi figures, as you can see. They can crouch like hell and be posed in a bunch of ways, which I just love. I think they're really nice. Very, very cool indeed. The Japanese love these. Look at that. I mean, you don't get that in a Marvel Legend. Nor do we necessarily, I would suggest most people would want to, because it just goes ball joint crazy, but something close. There we go. There's the previous Deadpool. Looks pretty good. Yeah. Very cool figures. I had that Yamaguchi figure, but it was insane, the articulation. Kind of drove me nuts, actually. It's almost too much. But there we go. That was just me. I don't think we missed anything, have we? No? No? Cool.
I don't think so.
Next part of the show is the juicy part of the show. The one where the 136 cool kids hang out, and that is at instagram.com/StarWarsTheBlackSeries. One of Matt's many curation pages where he pulls together a lot of content and the best content, really, the best toy photography, and in this case, Star Wars The Black Series. And he's pulling this together just for you and I, just so we can get to see all this good stuff. So just going through some of the images that we've got. This wave, as you said, is beginning to hit both. I mean, it has hit in some cases overseas and is hitting the US just now. I think Darkside and some retail outlets have begun to pop up with them. Nice pick here. That's just another example of just really simple but great photography. She has picked 66. Looks good, man. I like it. I like it a lot. Let me move this out of the way. What else we got? New Anakin as well. I am in love with that figure. I take it you opened yours, or have you had a chance to?
I haven't opened it yet, but I am opening it. I got a couple of multiples. So.
Oh my goodness, God, it's such a good figure. Something about it's just phenomenal. So, Papa Palpatine photography. Go for Papa Palpatine is showing how he did it with some cardboard, I think, with a little bit of polyfiller or something. Get on and nice. What a nice effect. Do some ripples, do some polystyrene foam maybe down the bottom. That's, wow, that looks great, man. A couple of 3D effects, 3D printed pieces, some lights, got the cables. That's awesome. What a great way to show off how you can do it. That's really good. And there we go, the final version, and then add in the figures. Damn, that's cool, man. That looks the bomb. I like it. Such a good figure. Good job there by Papa Palpatine Photography. Very, very good job indeed.
Did you get the snow speeder in the end?
It's not shipped yet. So did you?
I lost my job at the time, so not yet. But I've got a new job, so yeah. I've got to think about it.
You got to think about it. You got your figure now to go in the front of the snow speeder, plus you get DAC, plus you get the grappling gun. It's gonna happen, man.
I'll do it.
This is a really nice mold. There's some touch-ups, obviously, with the lightsabers and the eyes, but GoZed did a nice job, I think. I like it. That's even that one. There's nothing jumps out particularly special from that, but there's some flames in the background. Just a really nice angle and a kind of macro photography in that one, but it just does a good job.
A good pose goes so far.
It is. It really is. You're right. And the reflection on the helmet just looks great. It's a great looking figure, that. But she ain't no removable helmet. But Star Warsaholic looking very good in that pick. Nice job. Not quite sure what Boba's doing with the probe droid, but there we go. Solo. Oh, okay. I get it. Tank 666. Nice job. Nice photograph. He's got the goggles. I like it. He's following up on Han. Bit of Mythos Obi-Wan there. That's nice. Nice touch. Oh,
it could be, what do you call it? Rebels Obi-Wan as well. Although it is Mythos, but we did see him on a dewback on that Twin Suns episode.
I like the Tusken Raider piece there. And I think a Stormtrooper or somebody's rifle there. No, that
Luke's blaster.
Luke's,
what do you call it? His land speeder blaster or rifle.
Looks good. Very nice picture. Just nice lighting and kind of sunset-like vibe that goes on. This one just caught my eye as well, just purely to the point, they're so shiny.
Yeah.
They look great. They look really, really good. Death Troopers are still cool. They really are. There's that hashtag again, TBSFF. Looking good. A blurg. It's nice. Lots of Hoth vibes.
Surely we'll get one of them.
One of what?
A blurg.
A bloke.
We should get a blurg with the little Ugnaught.
I think so. Anything Mandalorian is a very strong game, that's for sure. That's a really creepy Palpatine pick. Ooh, I am all the Sith. Very good job there from the Outer Rim, literally. As he sat there on the Outer Rim. And some nice shots there of bounty hunters. They're really cool. Again, there's something about that poster that just really works well. And the background and the blotting and the nice job.
And that's the anniversary Zuckus or Forlom, whatever you want to call him.
Forlom, yeah, I agree. What's going on, Baby Yoda?
So this is a Gregory Titus piece. Not that he did it. It's what he's calling fan art, because obviously he didn't get to do the drawing because the Baby Yoda pack had no art on it. It just had the Mandalorian title treatment.
Gotcha.
So it's kind of a what if, but it's a bit of fan art.
Nice. It's a really nice piece of art from.
And then a mock-up of what it could have looked like.
The child. Good job, Gregory. Lots and lots of lightsabers swirling, all looking good. Looking very
check
good.
Out that lava one. Go back up. Yeah.
Isn't this the set we saw before? Sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, it's a set we saw before from Sean, Captain Auto.
Yeah.
And it's basically based on, you know, those early talks and Ralph Macquarie artwork of the final duel happening in the lava throne room.
Yep.
So it's kind of like a what if Return of the Jedi.
Well, it's nice. Yeah, that Ralph Macquarie artwork with the kind of Vader's castle.
That's yeah.
Really kind of shows up. Nice. Lots and lots of Luke's and Snowspeeders because he's awesome. Obviously touched up, but damn, that looks good. Black Series on that one for Darth Maul. Still a great figure. Still loads of people hunting for this figure. Just like, what? I don't know how they missed the archive line, but some of the people seem to like waiting for stores, and it's like, you know, can you see some of this stuff in stores? But there we go. That looks fantastic. That's so out of a movie. Star Wars Rick, which is probably the movie in the background on a screen, I would imagine, because it looks so good.
I would assume so.
Yeah, they know Star Wars Rick. Nice job. What's going on with Vader here?
It's based on one of the comic covers, if you click through.
Oh, is it the Dr. Aphra one, maybe? No, can't remember.
Have a look. Have a click through on the... It's got the thing behind it.
Oh, okay. It's recent anyway.
Yeah.
Okay. What a creepy thing Vader is. Ooh. What have we got here? Very nice. Nobody seems to have got the right Cody with the missing chin piece. Bit of a shame. Everything Kylo looks good. All looking good. This guy's coming back again. Woohoo! Carso Toy Photography. Nice job. It's a good figure. What else we got here? Nice thematic themes and colours going on. There's one I've not seen in a while. Grievous. Looks awesome. As he slices and dices heads. That's superb.
Captain Auto again.
Oh my God, look at that. All the work. Oof. Dear Lordy. A lot of work indeed. Jet troopers. Oh, there's a cat.
Yeah.
That's really nice, that shot there. Just the facial scan face just makes it look really good. Trooperi again, we've showcased a lot of him before. That looks nice. I've got a couple of hot soldiers, and it really is quite easy to manipulate and change them around, and it just looks really good. It's missing a strap on the rifle. That's the one thing I miss. It would be nice to add that.
But oh, they don't have it? I haven't opened mine yet.
No, there's no strap on it, no. Dooku is very popular right now. A lot of people are still hunting him down, but he's looking fantastic. Looks very good there with Grievous. twirly moustache. Twirly moustache villain. Very cool indeed. I like it. More space walls. Wow, that's a busy, busy photograph. Cara Dune kicking ass. I love that. That stormtrooper's looking like, what the fuck? Yeah. Blast effects. That's awesome. Really nicely staged. Well done, Plastic Thunder. Very cool, very cool.
The pose of that, the ability to hold that lightsaber of the Luke Skywalker figure is awesome.
It is. It's a little hard to get to hold that properly, but yeah, it does work. Mini Heinekens. I like it. Luke again, phenomenal figure. If you have not yet bought that Luke, you definitely need to buy it. Yes, yeah, saw that as well. My Star Wars order on Amazon shipping. I will destroy you. It's terrible what they did to these figures, but there we go. Nice shot even there of Cal Kestis and Rey and Luke and Obi with all the blades. That is nice. Who made that? Can we plug Foot for Productions? Oh, and others too. That's cool. Very nice indeed. See, somebody's got the shiny chrome trooper. I don't know how they got it, but they got it.
Yeah, is this one of them?
Don't know.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. It is. So they've started to ship. I saw that even this week they've started to arrive with some of the online sellers.
Good. The aesthetic. More Hoth troopers. And we're back to the beginning. Now, Matt's got a few pages. Is there any other pages quickly you want to...
We may as well have a look at 6-inch Legends and we can probably look at G.I. Joe really quickly.
Okay.
So...
Talk about Haslam. There. Just let me know if we're...
People are getting the Spidey wave in different places.
Yes. It's beginning to process. The Great Punisher, really good one. The new Spidey is looking fab, Aruni.
He just looks awesome. I can't wait.
Really, really good. Lots of nice pictures. It's a nice one there. Rogue and, sorry, not Rogue.
Jean Grey.
Jean Grey, thank you. Little Love Triangle pack. Oh my God, the horrible Wolverine looks not bad there.
Yeah.
Pretty good. Some of the X-Men there and Archangel. Very cool. That's a nice shot, actually. That really is quite well put together. Good job, Alistianto. Miles Morales, still a great figure. Doom with a gauntlet. I like that.
One of my all-time favorites.
I know. Yeah, Kraven. Did you ever get the good Kraven that you wanted? No.
Okay. Yes, I got both Kravens now.
Good, good. Good, good, good. But a beast.
That's a that Hulk up there, the Green Hulk, is a I bent my man thing from the Fawoosh. He has molded and repainted a Red Hulk head. So that's the Red Hulk head painted green.
Oh, nice. That looks quite good. Damn. Yes, I agree, Kat. It's good. Yeah, that was a nice head sculpt. I like it. Daredevil and Electros. I think we showed these Electros the last time. Maybe I'm wrong.
Maybe this is where we've got to. Yeah, that's it.
Any other toy news, links, things that you can think of we're missing? Or I think we've covered most of it.
Yeah.
So between now and episode 65, we're going to get some Marvel 20th Century Fox releases, reveals. Hasbro's doing a live panel. It was hinted at the last panel, excuse me, which is NED.
Sometime this week or next week marks the 20th anniversary of Fox's X-Men release.
Mm. So there will be more Marvel Fox X-Men reveals. There is some new other stuff going up very, very soon. We can't say when, but very, very soon. So stay tuned for that. And it's pretty good.
SDCC Online will happen in between now. this in our next show.
So we'll do another show as soon as it comes out and scoop up all the news and the deals from there. That's going to be really weird doing it. Well, I guess for most of the SDCCs in my life, it's been remote. But yeah, that's going to be kind of weird that it's just non-event, non-hall. Anyway, stay safe, wear a mask, do all that stuff. I think that's it, yeah? That's us?
I think so, yeah.
Cool, cool. We'll see you for episode 65, guys. See you later.
See ya.